Nehemiah began to pray. He went to the king. He had such a high position in the palace of the king. He was the cupbearer. That means he is the guy who tested the king's food before the king ate the food. If the food was poisonous, he was the one who was supposed to die. So that was a special kind of a position in the palace, equivalent to the governor of that time. So he went for King Artaxerxes. And prior to that, the people of Nehemiah had requested to rebuild the wall of Jerusalem. And King Artaxerxes said, "No, you cannot rebuild those walls. You are my slaves. You serve me the rest of your lives." But after prayer, Nehemiah went to the king, and God gave him favor. The same king who had said, "You cannot rebuild the walls of Jerusalem," is the same king, after Nehemiah finished praying, who said to Nehemiah, "You can go and rebuild the walls."
Amen.
He is the same king who gave Nehemiah security to accompany him on the way to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem. Amen. It is the same king who said no, who took material, building materials, and allowed Nehemiah to go and rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
Amen.
The Bible says he found favor in the presence of God. And the same favor gave him favor before the king. How? He knew how to pray. He knew how to pray. When you pray, even those that were against you, they will come bending low. That's what the Bible says in the book of Isaiah. In chapter 2, we see him going, not only empty-handed. They were slaves, remember, in that time. They were slaves. But you know, when he walked out of the palace, he had a letter of authority in his hand. You didn't get me.
Amen.
I said Nehemiah was a what?
A slave.
But after praying, the king released him. You know, that time you could not just go and ask for whatever you want before a king.
Amen.
You would be killed. You would die. But prayer gave him access.
Amen.
You guys, you didn't get me. I said prayer gave Nehemiah access.
Amen.
Access to the things he wanted to do. The Bible says he took his time to pray. He took his time to pray. He remembered what God promised in the scriptures to his people. And he knew that their people were being disgraced. They were being shamed. They were being mocked. They were being laughed at. The arrow that he used was prayer. In chapter 2, we see him now in Jerusalem. He did not just arrive in Jerusalem and started building. He took his time. He prayed. He prayed. He prayed. After praying, he said in chapter 11, "I rose up and started going right round the broken walls of Jerusalem." He started going around the walls of Jerusalem. The broken walls. Yeah. Remember, these walls were broken. Broken walls of Jerusalem. He started going, watching, looking at them. What's broken? There are people who pray, they don't even know what they want to pray for. They just pray it in blindness. You need to know, what are you praying for? What do you want?
Amen.
Mr. Chinzi, God is asking you, what do you want? You don't just pray haphazardly. You must be strategic. You want to hit the bullseye in prayer? You don't pray anyhow. You must be very, very strategic in your prayers. This is why when we are praying, we give you a guideline of the 21 days of prayer. They are meant to help you. That's not what you're just going to be praying for. It is called a guideline to help you to strategize the way you're going to pray for 2019. Hallelujah. He began to inspect the walls. And then he took people, he positioned them. As he positioned people, war arose. It is not good to just pray by yourself in your house. This is why we call for corporate prayer. You don't know who has got a heaven that is open in that moment in time. When we say pray for the person on your right, you don't know how that prayer is going to do for you. When we say pray for the person on your left, you are joining hands. You don't know what that prayer is going to do for you. It's good to pray for yourself. But the Bible says there is power in the multitude of voices raised before God Almighty. They came together to rebuild the walls. Nehemiah could not have done it by himself. No matter how powerful he is, he was a great man of God, but he could not do it by himself. He needed you and me. You need each other. You cannot do it by yourself. You need somebody to help you. You need somebody to motivate you. You need somebody to tell you it is possible. You need